Imagine you're offered to give up 30 minutes of your morning time in exchange for a free magic pill. The pill improves your learning capability, reduces your anxiety and stress, improves your mood and motivation, and generally it makes you a better version of yourself for the rest of the day. So, would you take that offer? Well, what I just described is the reason why you should exercise. When you think of exercising, the first thing that comes to your mind are the benefits or maybe losing weight or having a healthier heart. But the real benefits of exercise happen in the brain. So, what is the brain for anyway? You may think it's about solving math problems or creating a new smartphone app that will make you a millionaire. But neuroscientist Daniel Wolpert says that our brain is for one thing only: to produce adaptable and complex movement. That's it. The koala is a great example. In the past, it had a much bigger brain. But once it adapted its digestive system to derive all the energy it needs from eucalyptus leaves, it didn't have to move as much. Less movement meant less brain activity, and its brain shrunk. Studies have shown that there is a very powerful connection between the brain and movement. A big brain is needed to facilitate complex movements, and executing such movements and getting your heart rate up enhances your brain power. Exercise has been shown to help people better deal with stress and anxiety, improve mood, focus, and motivation. A 2007 study has shown that exercise also primes the brain to learn faster. Subjects who did high-intensity training beforehand were able to learn vocabulary 20% faster than those who remained sedentary. This phenomenon is due to a protein called Brain Derived Neurotrophic Factor, or BDNF for short. BDNF helps to support the survival of existing neurons and encourages the growth and differentiation of new neurons and synapses. In the brain, it is active in the hippocampus, cortex, and the basal forebrain, areas vital to learning, memory, and higher thinking. A 2013 study showed that only 20 to 40 minutes of aerobic exercise increased the BDNF in the blood by around 32%. So the reason why exercise is a key trigger for all kinds of positive effects in the brain, particularly learning, is because movement signals to the brain that something important is happening. Maybe not in modern times, but in the past, the reason to move was for the sake of survival. You move to escape a predator, to find a shelter, hunt for food, etc. And while moving, it's in your best interest to remember the lay of the land, so don't get lost and you can locate forageable food again. When attacked by a predator, you better remember which path was most efficient to escape, so you can prevent yourself from becoming a tiger's meal the next time. When you're sitting on your couch watching television, you signal your brain that nothing important is happening and it's time for rest. Exercise also affects the areas of the brain responsible for motivation and action. The reward center is one of the most important areas in the brain. Dopamine is a key player in the reward system. From an evolutionary perspective, dopamine is released when we expect some kind of reward. It makes us want to do stuff and reassures us that the thing we did was worth doing. So if your reward system is not working properly, you might have a hard time to get things done. If your brain doesn't expect a reward and fulfillment from something, it won't justify doing it. There are pills that can help with this, but you don't have to buy any kind of drugs to get your reward system going. Studies show that exercise boosts motivation by increasing dopamine storage and increasing the creation of dopamine receptors in the brain. It might not make you stay up all night in a studying frenzy like Adderall, but it will give you more willpower and focus to do those little things that don't usually feel rewarding. But even though your reward center might be working just fine, you are feeling great and you are satisfied with your ability to learn, you can still improve all of these areas. When you exercise, you might not feel a drastic change all of a sudden, but later on, you will look back and notice the difference in learning speed, mood, focus, and you will get more things done. Now that you know all the benefits of exercise, it's up to you whether or not you will take the magic pill and improve your life, or you will stay the same and get the same results you've always had. Anyway, if you want to learn how muscles work and actually grow when exercising, you should go over to my friend at Food for Thought and watch his video on this topic. And if you don't want to miss my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.